of a car. Actually, he's already got one. He lost it this week, and this is Pumpkin that he's running now. He also ran this car at Charlotte, guys.
Yeah, Dave, you're right, but I'll tell you what, I don't know how free I would want the car at the start of the race. It would be good, I think, once the race started, but this place is so fast, and everybody is nose to tail at this race. Boy, it would be, it'd be a little bit scary to have a free race car at the start.
It's NASCAR Winston Cup final practice from the Atlanta Motor Speedway. The new Wally Dollar Doll on sale here. Happy Hour from Atlanta Motor Speedway on TNT is brought to you by Stacker 2, the world's strongest fat burner. Burn fat, crush cravings, and supercharge your energy. By Napa Auto Parts, Napa, we keep America running. And by Suzuki, maker of innovative motorcycles and all-terrain vehicles, proud sponsor of the Heisman Trophy Award. Final practice ongoing here in Atlanta. Jeff Gordon will take the green flag tomorrow from seventh starting spot. Right there. Just about 200 miles an hour at that point in the racetrack.
Yep, and you're just getting out of the gas just a little bit. You're not getting out of it much. What do you got going on down there in the garage right now, Benny?
Mark Martin's car, the Viagra car, a little bit too tight, so they're riding, trying to raise the track bar, put a rubber in the right rear spring, loosen it up. Kevin Harvick talking about being loose. Mark Martin talking about being a little bit too tight.
So adjustments on the third place man in the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. Just four races to go in the season, and that title fight will be a big story in tomorrow's Napa 500. Matt Yoakam.
Allen, Jimmy Johnson, second in points, has pulled the Lowe's Chevrolet back into his garage stall. He was loose on the gas in the first session. He wasn't happy with his shock package, so they changed that for this session. The car still a little loose, turned 9,400 RPM on that last run. Right now, Chad Knaus is talking on the radio to Jimmy about what changes to try now, just to make this car better. Now, keep in mind, this is not the same race car that Jimmy finished third with here in the spring. This is a car actually built for Bristol. It's a little bit different aerodynamic package, which they feel like will be much better when he's running in traffic. He'll cut through the traffic much better, unlike the Charlotte car, which he developed an aero push. Alan?
A car to run on the high bank, half mile Bristol track here in Atlanta.
I can understand that theory, because you're looking for a car that's got a lot of downforce. And this is a place that downforce is your friend.
Earnhardt Jr.'s had a lot of downforce here the last couple of times he's raced in Atlanta. Last two finishes here, seventh and second. Came up just short of Tony Stewart in the spring race here.
Yeah, Earnhardt Jr.'s definitely got to watch for tomorrow's race. He's always gets around this place good. He's at the top of charts right now.
And as you saw by the graphic, of late, he's been one of the hottest drivers in NASCAR Winston Cup racing. Really been knocking off the top 10 finishes here lately. And there's your championship leader, Tony Stewart. Going to bring the field down from the pole tomorrow. Doesn't get credit for a Bud Pole Award because he didn't qualify it, but he'll take that number one starting spot in the rain.
And he'll be a tough guy to be here. He gets around this racetrack as good as anyone.
Hey, Wally.
Yes, sir.
Remember in the spring, Tony Stewart, believe it or not, ran the high groove most of the day. We always expect to see him on the bottom. In the high groove most of the day, he's telling his spotter right now, as soon as somebody moves up to that second group, let me know. I want to go up there and check it out for tomorrow.
Well, actually, Benny, I've been watching the guys down in 3 and 4, and there are a lot of cars that are running high already, which is, I'm a little bit surprised, because I know the track's been green. They got a little running this morning, but they are starting to work that groove up in 3 and 4 anyway. 1 and 2, they're also, there's about 3 or 4 cars running high in 1 and 2, so.
And Tony's not one of them?
Not yet.
Uh-huh, must be really good on the bottom so far then.
He's hanging right on that line around the inside of both ends of the track, BP. Got a great Pumpkin scene there on the head of that car.
And there he's making a move on the 8 car, Junior, which is getting around this place good right now, so.
Now, the one thing you don't know when you're watching something like this is, what tires do they have on? Does Stewart have on brand new tires and Junior's on older tires? Or, you know, you really can't tell that here.
No, but, you know, most of the guys here, Alan, I would think, would start out on sticker tires here to start out on Happy Hour. But I'm sure somebody down there is going to prove me wrong. What do you say, Matt?
Wallet out in the Ricky Rudd garage. He's been struggling much of the week, and in fact, last night he was extremely happy that NASCAR called qualifying and lined up the field by points. He will now roll off 10th instead of way out, probably a provisional. He said during this session the car is loose, tight on entry into turn one, but loose over the rest of the racetrack. He was 27th in the first practice, 23rd this practice. The car again, a little snug in the middle. They're going to make a shock change on the left rear. And one other comment that Ricky told Fatback McSwain and Scrucci, the car is bouncing and dipping on the racetrack. Not a comfortable feeling. A caution on the racetrack for debris.
And there it is. Guesses as to what that is?
Well, it doesn't look like Benny's gloves.
Yeah.
Threw out of the window last week, so.
Here's the Wendy's Race Menu. Coverage of the Napa 500 tomorrow on NBC, 12 noon Eastern Time. Just four races remaining to decide who'll be the NASCAR Winston Cup champion for 2002. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. Tuesday night, the drama of NBA opening night is on TNT. Allen Iverson and the Sixers take on Tracy McGrady and the Magic in game one. While in the nightcap, Tim Duncan and the Spurs take on the world champion Lakers. Starts at 7 p.m. Eastern as the NBA tips off on TNT Tuesday night. Back under the green flag again after the looked like a garbage bag got picked up off the main straightaway. Here's Jamie McMurray out practicing the very same car that he won at Charlotte in a couple of weeks ago.
He's trying to probably figure this place out. This is, like I said, this is a tough racetrack to get around. And looking for that comfort level right now.
Now, somewhere out in the middle of the masses in the infield is Marty Snyder.
And I mean in the middle of the infield, Alan.
Yes, you are.
I am down here, and I'm hanging out by the bus, and you see the bus is progressing along nicely. People have come by to add a little paint, add a little bit of everything they wanted to it. Here's a message to BP. It says, we want the bus. We are the Upers. What are Upers? I don't know what that is. From across the street at Martinsville, those are some of your friends, BP from Virginia. Everybody wants to know what the reason of the bus. This is the reason of the bus. The fans are here hanging out. They're having a good time. They're hanging out by the bus. And I tell you what, 100,000 of these fans, 100,000 voted at NASCAR.com and at NBCSports.com. And we do have a name for the bus, finally. All I can tell you is it has the word the in it. That's all we've gotten so far. We're going to finish the rest of the name. And the bus has had many improvements. In fact, I think the bus is very nearing completion. Let's see if we can find out what's inside. What do you think about the bus real quick? Do you like the bus? You don't?
You do?
You going to hang out in the bus today and watch the race from the up top?
I don't know.
You don't know? You gonna let her watch the race from up top?
Sure, why not?
Very good, everybody wants to get in the bus. Let's go inside and see what's going on inside the bus today. And I believe we have some new things inside the bus. Indeed we do, it's now furnished as well. So now the outside and the inside, the people from Aaron's have given us some nice new furniture. The girls from Aaron's are here. They brought the furniture, but they left a lot of their clothing at home. But you know what? That's okay. So they are here showing off the furniture. We got a little radio in here for you, Wally. So, you know, you can come in here and listen to the radio and hang out on the bus. And this is what the bus is for people to come and enjoy the race, sit inside. There's even water in here. You can have a nice view of the race from up top. How about that, Wally?
That's why I want to go down this to listen to the radio.
Yeah. So you can and so you can watch the race. Well, you don't want to talk to these girls, do you, Wally?
No.
Oh, of course not, because, you know, Robin would not like that at all. Oh, would she?
Marty,
yes,
you should stop there.
I am.
I would.
That would be my cue for you to go, Alan.
Thank you. How about race cars?
What race cars? those race cars.
Okay. Mark Martin. Let's see. Benny told us making that little adjustment there a little while ago. Dale Jarrett's got the second fastest lap in the practice so far. Dave Burns is with him.
And he's trying to make it faster. DJ, what's the crew doing for you right now?
The car's pretty good right there. It was reasonably fast and stayed with me pretty good. We've just got another set of shocks that we want to try to see if that may give me a better feel to where I can really go hard.
Second on the chart, but always trying to go faster. Matt?
Dave, the fastest car during this final practice session is Dale Earnhardt Jr. in the Budweiser Chevy. He said the car was getting better and better, and then it started hopping the right rear, so they pulled it in. He thought he also had possibly a flat rear tire or something, because he had a vibration in the right rear. They did change the front springs. All the tires were up. He just felt like something wasn't right. He has gone back out. They're also talking about some other changes. They just want to try an A-B something, just to see if maybe something might be a little bit better, but they're very confident in the setup they have in the car now.
And every little thing is magnified here in Atlanta, because you're going so fast. So any little problem you feel with the car feels like a big problem because of the speeds here you carry in Atlanta.
You have options in your viewing experience tomorrow. If you've got digital cable and you want to check out NASCAR in-car on in-demand, 5 in-car camera channels with virtual dashboards, real-time in-car data, and live team audio are available. 1-888-SPORTS-IN is the number, and that's only on digital cable. You could ride with Junior all day if he's rolling the cameras. Set up tomorrow. Earnhardt Jr. led 171 laps of this race 1 year ago. Remember, he got something in his eye late in the race last year and lost some positions near the end because he was having trouble seeing.
Yeah, I remember that.
And there's Ryan Newman, going to start sixth tomorrow. Fifth in the championship standings, looking for his second win of 2002. Final practice from Atlanta, back in a minute on TNT. I got a lesson for you here. Don't ever loan your rent-a-car to the pit reporters to go into the infield.
Wow.
They might not bring it back in the same condition in which you gave it to them.
That is a crash.
Yep. Yep. So,
how'd you do that, Marty?
Next time Marty wants to ride you about,
I know better.
Bouncing your race car off the wall.
All I can say is I have no citation from that accident, okay? That's all I have to say about that.
Uh-huh.
Although I was a material witness to the accident.
Uh-huh.
That's all I have to say.
Okay. That's because you
caused
it.
That's all I can say in a court of law, because anything can be used against me. And I know that if anything I say on this program or anywhere near this program, you guys will use it against me.
You've caught on to that by now, have you?
Yeah, you know, one, a year and a half ago.
There's last week's winner, Kurt Busch. His car looks a lot prettier than that other Taurus did.
Yes, it does. A lot faster. Right now he is seventh.
Yep.
And running good laps after, let's see, he's run 14 laps.
And Kurt's going to start in eighth place tomorrow, lined up according to owner points. Ricky Craven going to give a go at it tomorrow. Dave is with him.
And Alan, he's standing by watching his crew make some changes. You've been out of the car for a few minutes now. What are they changing and why?
They're making some small changes. That's a good thing. You know, whenever a team is relaxed, like the Ty team is right now, and they're making some small changes, that means you're close. And I'm really comfortable in the Ty Ford. The same car we ran so well with last fall, and the same car we ran top five this spring. And I'm pretty excited.
It sounds like you're having fun out there, too, like the Atlanta track is a fun one for racers.
It is. Yeah, it's like we said earlier, it's as it gets older, it seems to be getting better. You've given more options. When it was first rebuilt and paved, it wasn't my favorite. In fact, I just flat didn't like it because it was hard to race. But now there are several options, and I think as a race car driver, that's what you look for. If your car doesn't want to run the bottom, well, give me a few laps. We'll find a place that it likes. And the Tide Ford likes the middle of the racetrack right now, so I think we got options to the bottom, options to the top. And historically, this has been a good track for us. So everything's great, except I miss my wife and two kids. So if you'd get down here, I'd be a lot happier.
All right, and they've seen you now. So, hey, BP, what's going on with the championship leader?
Well, Tony Stewart said the car needed to be just a little bit better. Came in, the car, they made a change in the rear of the car. The crew told him to go out, try this for 8 or 10 laps. If you like it, we'll put on some new tires, run those about 15, 20 laps, and flash, we are done.
Okay. Well, let's see if he likes it when he comes back in.
19 laps he's run, and last lap was 31-1. And that is a good lap on 20 lap tires.
Okay, Matt, you have something relating to the Great Pumpkin? Or
or something like that. Bobby Hamilton Sr. not riding solo in the 55 car this week, and he has a little sidekick. A young race fan by the name of Jesse who lives outside of the Buffalo, New York area, gave Bobby a racing Winnie the Pooh bear to put in his race car this weekend. Jesse bought the bear when Bobby got hurt at Richmond. He wrote Bobby a letter saying he wanted something to protect him in the race car and bring him some good luck, so he sent the Pooh bear. The race team, not wanting to be black flagged like Benny was at Martinsville, keeping with NASCAR safety practices, made a little Hans device so he is secured safely in the race car. And by the way, Winnie says the car's a little bit tight up off turn two, so they made a spring change in the left rear.
Hey, Matt, maybe after the race, Bobby can lend that bear to Marty.
Quite possibly. We can work out some kind of deal. Bobby has been known to work some deals in his racing past, so maybe if Mr. Snyder can come on by the 55 garage, we'll see what happens. And it's sprinkling.
Ah, okay. I was just going to ask. There's a red flag out. What it's for? And that answers the question, Matt. It is raining. BP.
And I knew it was raining before Matt because he has hair. We talked about all the animals. You know, Tony Stewart, when he won the race here in the spring, had the hula hoop girl in the back bobbing around. I looked in the package tray in the back of the car. It isn't there. Maybe it couldn't last the entire season, huh?
I don't know.
Matt?
Well, Benny, at the spring race earlier this year, the hula girl actually hula herself to death. She actually broke apart. The team used safety wire and bungee corded her back together with tie wraps. She made a few more races, and then she was no more.
There we go. I would say if you're moving that fast back and forth for 500 miles here in Atlanta, you're going to have some problems at the end of the day, huh?
She's going to be sick.
That would be a bobblehead to the extreme. Red flag is out. Rain here at the Atlanta Motor Speedway. You're watching NASCAR on TNT. Primetime college football on TBS tonight, and it's a good one. The Nebraska Cornhuskers in College Station to take on the Texas A&M Aggies. It's Big Play Saturday, 7 Eastern tonight on the Superstation. A little bit of a light sprinkle falling here. You see the pace car out on track now with Buster Auten, the driver behind the wheel, trying to see if conditions are okay to send the cars back out. No windshield wipers going on the car. That's good news, huh, BP?
That's great news. I got with me Matt Borland, the crew chief for Ryan Newman, the Alltel Ford. Remember, he was the first pole qualifier for Martinsville last week, and the engineer had to wear, a graduate of Clemson, had to wear a South Carolina jersey all weekend. This weekend was Matt's turn, the crew chief's turn. If Ryan had qualified on the pole, you would have had to be what?
A chicken.
A chicken. Now, you convinced me that you aren't glad that qualifying was rained out.
Now, we would have liked to get an opportunity to qualify up the front. It's always fun to try and qualify, but, you know, if I had to wear the chicken suit, it'd be worth it.
I mean, how big is this chicken suit? Do you have it here on the truck?
I haven't seen it yet, but I think Ryan's girlfriend's taking care of making sure it's as embarrassing as possible.
Matt, you're glad that you aren't glad that didn't qualify?
No, but I'm glad I don't have to wear it.
I bet he is. Matt?
Benny, Jeff Gordon was first in the first session, currently third in this final practice session. The DuPont guy is under the car. Jeff, how's the race car?
Car's great. It's real fast on new tires, obviously, with some of the lap times we run. But, you know, the track is not really where it's going to be race time tomorrow or when we get into the race. It's not moved up far enough. We're going to be up against the wall and down, you know, on the white line. My car's great around the bottom right now, but I wish we could get the track moved up. So, and I might run a little bit there before this practice is over.
I heard you say earlier on the radio that the car was tight. Have you fixed the tight?
We're working on that. That's pretty much a characteristic of Atlanta. You know, we started out this morning and cars were not very tight, you know, a little free. And as we run and get rubber down, it gets tighter and tighter and tighter. And the more you run and the pressure's built up, the track gets tighter. So, you know, we're too good on new tires. I think right now we need to be a little bit freer probably so we can be better on the long run.
Well, Jeff Gordon, the last Atlanta starts, has two victories. Now he feels like he's out of the points championship, just chasing wins now, Marty.
Matt, I'm hanging out with Danny. This is Danny. He's on my team. He'll play an interception. I'm all-time quarterback. This is Taylor, all right? So we're hanging out because it's raining, and that's what you do in the infield, all right? Danny, go. I don't know what pattern Danny's going to run, but he's going to run something like that. Oh, Danny. That was a bad throw. A little bit behind him.
Yes, so. It was a bad throw.
Thank you. I just threw a great touchdown.
See, you
ago.
And Alan do have something in common.
Oh, no. Let me put my mic down, Wally, okay?
Very nice. Thank you, Wally.
Run a little slant.
All right, here we go. Here's our football audition. Snyder drops back, throws, overthrows the receiver. He overthrows the receiver.
I hit him in the hands.
It's not the receivers. Marty.
Taylor, it's your turn, buddy.
Marty.
Andy, you got to play defender. What?
This report was supposed to be about what's going on the bus.
Alan. Well, the bus.
Goodness.
People are painting. People are painting the bus. We're working on the back of the bus right now. And there's a bunch of people on the side painting the name. That's a secret right now, though, okay? Benny's going to come over here in a minute, I think. All right, go, Taylor. What are you going to do? Well, I like that, Taylor. Ah!
What's the wonder?
Man.
And he runs it right into the motorhome.
What's
nice
the wonder
guy.
Nobody can...
You know,
the kind of football they're using, it's no wonder nobody can catch
yeah.
it.
Yeah, very good point. See the ladder we're working on right there? See, anyone in Rockingham who's coming to Rockingham, if you have an extra ladder, bring the ladder. We need to attach one to right there. And someone had a really great idea to try and put a slide coming down it. So, you know, if you guys want to get creative at Rockingham and try to put a slide on this thing, go for it, because we need a way to get down easier than me, because I'm afraid of heights. I can't come down that ladder very well. What are you going to run, Taylor?
We could send Dave back out to do the slide
right,
thing
right,
then,
gonna
too.
Run flash, whatever that is. Go, Taylor. All right.
Yeah, here we go.
That's touchdown.
Here's
yes, finally. I completed a pass.
We weren't watching, Marty. We were watching Dave go down the slide at Pocono.
Oh, no. I completed a pass, and you guys
missed it. That was the
good
one, though.
That's not the one we wanted to see.
Yeah.
That's what we need on the bus. We need that on the bus. We really do. I mean, that'd be a lot more fun. Go, Taylor.
All right. That's fine. Another throw. Yeah. Oh, right. Intercepted.
Nice catch.
Touchdown. Hopefully the cars will get back out on the racetrack. It's got to be more entertaining than watching Marty throw. Up next here on TNT, after Winston Cup Happy Hour, the NASCAR Busch Series, Aaron's 312, season's longest race. Coming up in Atlanta, tomorrow on NBC, noon Eastern time, the Napa 500, as the race for the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship continues. Just rolled the cars back out onto the racetrack. It has stopped drizzling or misting, and the word is that the track is in good shape. And as the cars get up to full speed, why don't we check once again with Marty?
Well, I am by the bus, and BP's here.
Hey,
it's your first visit to the bus. What do you think about our little pad here?
This is the bus. May I look inside of it?
You may. You may. Go ahead, please. And we, of course, saw the brand new furniture earlier, and nice little trees and stuff in there. See?
Does somebody stay in this bus?
Dave does on the weekends, yeah.
Dave? Better man than I am, I'll tell you that.
All right, 100,000 of you spoke. Here's the name. The Pit Cruiser. Get it? C-E-R-E-W-S-E-R. Cruiser. So the Pit Cruiser. I think the bus is done, BP. What do you think? I mean, it's ready for fans to, you know, we're ready to activate this bus. Fans can come in, hang out on top. I think it's ready, don't you?
It looks good to me.
Now, what do we do when a boat's ready, BP?
You christen the thing.
Let's do it. All right, come on.
Okay.
Watch out, Donnie. All right. Heads up. BP's going to christen the bus.
All right, everybody, stand
back up. Here we go. This is the first time you've ever christened anything, BP?
Yes, it is. Now, just don't knock out the headlights, right?
There you go. Just don't knock out the headlights.
All right, everybody, look out.
This
the Pit Cruiser is...
Try the bumper.
They don't make bottles like they used to.
Strike one.
They make buses like they used to.
Or buses. Shall we try again?
Yeah.
All right.
Yay! All right. The bus is christened. It's open for business. And it'll be happening later today here.
Hey, you know the best part about this whole deal?
What's that?
I borrowed Wally's coat for this. Terrific.
I was just thinking that. That's right, BP. I still have your coat up here.
That's true.
All right, guys. The bus is open for business. Go have fun.
Okay. Racetrack's open for business, too.
Pass me that char mayonnaise, Alan.
Yeah, thank you. Couple sardines to put in the pockets.
Good idea. Good thinking.
Okay. Matt Kenseth, he could be tough tomorrow. Mm-hmm. 17 car. Matt's going to start in ninth place. Finished fourth here back in the March race. And already, of course, four victories in 2002 for Kenseth. Saw some people walking out of Martinsville last week with the cheesy, you know, the foam cheese with 17 stenciled on the side.
Looks like he's in that low line.
That's Joe Nemechek right behind him in the 25 car. How about Rusty Wallace? Where's Rusty? Rusty's 21st, yep. There's Rusty, fifth place. Start starting spot for tomorrow. Fourth in the championship standings where owner points are concerned. Where driver points are concerned. Remember Sterling Marlin, the 40 car gets a spot there in the owner point, so that's why the starting spots won't match exactly where they are in driver points. Matt, you got something on Rusty?
Well, he was fifth in the first practice and just outside the top 20 in this practice session. He just spoke on the radio to his crew chief, Billy Wilburn. He said their right front is real grippy. We may have to add some of that grip to the left side, but the car, pretty easy.
Yeah, probably what he means, I think, is probably the car's loose getting in. If the right front is really sticking, which is a pretty good thing here in Atlanta, but if it sticks too much.
I saw a caution light. Sorry, Wall.
It's probably loose in.
It's raining again. Or enough that they want to put the red flag out. I don't suspect that a track this fast you want to take any kind of chance with precipitation at all.
No.
So while they regroup and head back for pit road, let's check down in the garage some more. Dave?
Well, Alan, one of the things that Jimmy Johnson is using this practice session for is to break in a new helmet. This is the old one that he was wearing. He's got one very, very close to it in his car right now. Remember that they're constructed of a hard shell, very dense foam, and then next to the driver's face and head is a softer material. And Jimmy spent the last 10 minutes before he went back out there taking some of that material out of the new helmet around the ears. He said that it was a little bit tight. It was pressing his ears too tightly and actually putting them to sleep. So he himself, knowing the comfort level that he needed, got inside there, took this material out, and now is going to get it back out there, hopefully, and put it to the test.
Yeah, just about every helmet you get, you got to kind of have to modify a little bit. Add foam here, take foam out, and most of the time there's a lot of pieces in the ear area, and it hurts when it's too tight.
Personalized fit.
Yes.
So Jimmy Johnson, Tony Stewart, the other championship contenders wait once again as a little bit of rain peppers the Atlanta Motor Speedway. Stewart gonna start on the pole, and he's got the fastest lap in happy hour so far. Happy hour from Atlanta Motor Speedway on TNT is brought to you by Stacker 2, the world's strongest fat burner. Burn fat, crush cravings, and supercharge your energy. By Napa Auto Parts, Napa, we keep America running. And by Suzuki, maker of innovative motorcycles and all-terrain vehicles, and proud sponsor of the Heisman Trophy Award. As you can see, the brief little sprinkle has gone away. The cars back out on the track for their final moments of practice. Should see the red and black flags at any time now. Have they found the comfort zone?
The handling package is what we're looking for. Have they? Hope so.
Well, yeah, but
this is the last shot.
Yeah. And the flags are out, and final practice is over here in Atlanta. I'll tell you, one of the big things that's going to keep these crew chiefs guessing all night long, weather conditions. What'll it be for tomorrow? Let's see. BP was flagged. Some teams worked hard in their race cars to try and find that comfort zone. Marty got in trouble, probably.
Hope so.
The Great Pumpkin's got a good ride for tomorrow. Marty does not.
Marty got in trouble again.
Yeah. Marty can't pass. Good catch by the kid. And Wally's doll is doing well in the garage.
I want one of those.
BP, try it again. Christened successfully.